you again. Oke, Tony, hari ini aku mau kasih kalian berita istimewa. Jadi hari ini kita akan menyelesaikan atau mencarikan solusi sekaligus bersenang-senang bersama dengan puzzle baru. Apa itu? Askiart. Oh ya, aku mau nanya dong, kalian di sini ada yang tahu nggak sih apa itu Askiart? Art itu kan adalah seni ya, berarti seni ASCII. Kalian tahu nggak apa itu? Jadi, seni ASCII itu adalah seni yang dibuat dari karakter-karakter. Nah, karakter ini biasanya dirangkai dengan sedemikian rupa sehingga menyerupai bentuk atau tulisan tertentu. Nah, karakter ini tuh maksudnya bisa apa aja, bisa alfabet atau simbol-simbol seperti bintang, pagar, open parenthesis, gitu. Udah kebayang gak sih kayak apa? Biasanya kalau di dunia nyata kalian itu tahu atau pernah ngeliat di bandara atau stasiun kereta, biasanya kayak gini. Ini dia seni ASCII namanya. Keren kan? Nah, sekarang kita akan mencoba untuk mensimulasikannya. Yuk, penasaran? Langsung aja yuk, let's do it! Oke, keluarga Gading Hilliard! Oke, kita panggil yuk langsung aja. Halo Andrea.
Hi everybody.
Ciao.
Ciao. Mia. Ciao.
Come va?
Oh wow. Impressive. Impressionante. Bellissima Prisca. Hi everybody.
Oke, Golden Pudding. Jadi hari ini kita akan belajar puzzle baru, yaitu Askiart. Yep, here.
Here we are.
On the right. Yes. Wow, here we are.
Let's see what it is. Some of it.
We don't want to read?
Well, I think we can just explain the inputs and the outputs because today is about Excel, right?
Yes.
So in Excel, you know, we can't do these things. Yeah. We focus on the input and the output. But yeah, the idea is to create something like that, you know? Some big text.
Jadi nih kayak yang bisa kalian lihat di layar, the goal, kalau kalian baca di stasiun atau di bandara, kalian sering melihat tampilan seperti itu kan? Pernah nggak sih kalian itu bertanya pada diri sendiri gitu? Kayak misalnya, gimana mungkin untuk mensimulasikan tampilan ini pada terminal atau bandara gitu, ya kan? Sekarang kita akan menyelesaikannya di Excel.
Perfect. Okay, so in Excel we focus input and outputs, and let's see at the examples here. Yes.
Yes.
So input 4, 5, E.
E. Wow. What
so does that mean? Right? Oh my God. So this is a type of art.
Yes.
Yes. And this is the alphabet: A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So I think 5 means
it's
five rows. Yes. Mm-mm.
Jadi kalian kan bisa lihat nih di example 1, di situ kan ada input, yang mana di input itu tertulis kayak 4, 5, E, lalu seninya gitu ya kan. Nah, 4 itu apa sih? 4 itu adalah horizontal dari gambar ini, ya, 4. Lalu 5 itu vertikal ke bawah dari karakter ini. Ya, 5 itu adalah vertikal ke bawah dari karakter ini. Yap, itu ada 5 kalau kita hitung ke bawah. Dan E itu adalah input yang harus kita tunjukkan di akhir gitu, kayak E gitu ya, huruf E. Oke. Okay.
Perfect. So here they ask E, and the output must be E. Here they put Manhattan.
Yes.
Yes, and the output?
Manhattan.
Manhattan.
Oke. Okay. Okay. Kita lihat gimana cara menyelesaikannya. Let's do it.
Let's do it. Okay, perfect. So this time we start with an empty Excel.
Karena kalian kan pasti ingin tahu gitu ya, gimana caranya sih kita melakukannya. Nah, sekarang kita akan melakukannya dari nol. Alright.
So we can see also the formatting, completely everything.
Yes.
Alright.
Okay, jadi kalian juga bisa lihat formattingnya yang kita lakukan. Okay.
Perfect. Let's start with the inputs. Alright, now let's explain the secret of coding game. This beautiful button here.
Nah, kalian kan bisa lihat di sini ada test cases yang banyak ya kan. Test casesnya itu bukan cuma satu doang. Kalau biasanya kan di puzzle-puzzle sebelumnya cuma satu. Kalau di sini tuh banyak. Kita lihat apa aja itu. Test stick.
And wow. Here we see all the tests. Yeah, this was the first test.
Yeah, di sini
input.
Ada input dan outputnya itu minta E.
And then the other tests. Let's start with this one. Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so let's copy the inputs.
Kita copy dulu inputnya ya. Kita pindahin ke Excel. Alright.
Excel. And then we have to do paste special.
Paste special. Ya, lalu kita pilih teks. Karena kalau kita pilihnya HTML itu layar tampilannya akan putih, putih ketemu putih jadi transparan jadi nggak kelihatan. Oke. Okay.
So this is important. Not this, this. Okay.
Yes.
Alright. Perfect. But looks a bit ugly.
Yes. Di sini kayak nggak kelihatan gitu kan ya, ABCD-nya tuh alfabetnya itu nggak kelihatan, belum jelas. Oke, okay, kita akan mencarikan solusinya, yaitu dengan font. Mengganti font konsolas.
Okay, yep. Now looks better.
Sekarang kalian bisa lihat lah ya, seenggaknya gitu ini. A, itu B, C, D, E, E, okay.
Yeah. Another way of doing it, you select the cells you want to change, and then you press Ctrl 1.
Okay.
And this always open all
format
the possibility cell. For format.
Yes, okay.
Then you configure the font. Which is Consolas, the stickers, wonder font.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Great.
Wonderful. I don't like this font very much. Yes, so let's take another one. Yeah, let's take another example. Here, for example.
Nah, di sini ada contoh lain dari seni ASCII ini. Bentuknya kayak gini, alright.
So this would beautiful. Be Manhattan, yes. So let's check this one.
Kita ambil.
Copy.
Kita paste lagi di Excel.
Paste special.
Special kayak tadi ya.
Okay, another way of doing it is this.
Kita pilih teks. Lalu okay. Okay, here we are.
The font is not correct. Another way to correct something. If here is good and here is bad, yes, then one way of formatting it is you go where is good.
Yeah.
And then you press this button.
Oh, copy.
Format paint. You copy only the format. Yeah. Copy and then you put it where it's ugly. And voila. Good.
Good. Yay. Nah, kalian bisa lihat nih di sini. Let's give it a name.
Yes, good idea.
Kita kasih nama nih ya biar kalian itu tahu apa itu 20, apa itu 11. Yep. Let's see.
So we said that this is the
character width.
Width. Yes.
Okay.
And this we said height. In fact, let's say 1 2 look. Double click, remember? Yeah.
Double click lalu
11, yep. So is this 11.
11 itu ada karakter height 11.
And this is the input text, for example. Yes.
Nah, jadi yes. Jadi karakter width-nya itu ada 20, yang mana ke samping itu ada 20 karakter. Nah, ke bawah itu ada 11 karakter. Kalau kalian hitung, lalu di sini input text-nya itu kita kasih Manhattan.
Usually the inputs are blue, usually.
Kita kasih warna.
Dark blue.
Okay.
And let's make bold like this. Okay. Now let's give a name to these cells. Yeah. Last time we saw that you can click on the cell and write here the name.
Yep.
So we could do it. Mm-hmm. Yes. But there is another trick. I want to show you.
Yeah.
You can select the cells that you want to name.
To name.
Mm-hmm. And what you described to the left.
Okay. Yes.
And then you press Ctrl Shift F3.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you say, hey, I want to use what is on the left to give the names.
Yeah.
Okay, and now you named, you see, many cells just in one go.
Yeah.
Imagine you could do it with 20, 30 cells.
Jadi kalian bisa melakukannya secara otomatis kayak tadi, kalau kalian ingin kasih nama 20, 11, dan Manhattan ini sesuai dengan nama yang udah kalian kasih di sebelah kiri, kalian tinggal blok aja tadi yang mau kalian kasih nama. Setelah itu kalian pencet Ctrl, Shift, dan F3, okay? Alright.
Wonderful. So what do we have here? Here we have, in this cell, you see there is all the shape of all 27 characters of the alphabet, yes? And then when you go down here, you see there is this piece of the A, but then the B, the C, everything in one cell.
Yep. Jadi di sini tuh untuk sementara yang kalian lihat di tampilan layar ini A B C D E F G dan seterusnya itu ada dalam satu kolom doang. Yes. Sekarang kita mau pindahin A di kolom 1, B di kolom sebelahnya, C di kolom sebelahnya, kita pindahin begitu ya secara berurutan biar kalian mudah untuk memahami. Alright.
So instead, let's have each cell containing, you know, a piece of the letter A. So basically these cells will contain A, this B, this C, that's our intention. Okay, let's do that.
Yes.
So, usually computers hate text and strings. Uh-uh. They prefer numbers.
Yes.
But it's useful to learn to do also text and strings, and that is our lesson today, our tutorial.
Yeah. Yes, okay.
So let's learn about text and strings. All right. So let's create a formula to take only the A, and then here, only the
B. Yeah.
Okay, all right. So, when you don't know exactly what formula you want, you go to
function. FX, to function. Mm-hmm.
And then you search. You say, well, I want something from the middle of the text.
Yes.
And you can say, well, the category is text. Something to do with text.
Uh-huh.
You know? And here it shows you only the formulas with text.
Yes.
And then you say, I want something from the middle. Mm-hmm. You see, okay, if I do without these two, you know?
Kita langsung ditunjukkan secara otomatis yang dimana kalian tinggal pilih aja apa yang kalian butuhkan. Okay, this. Okay.
Yeah, and here they said, for example, mid returns the characters from the middle of a string.
Yeah.
Giving the start position and how many. That's perfect for us, yes?
Yes. Jadi kita akan pilih mid. Middle, okay.
So, let's try. First of all, text. So
kita ambil
this, yeah.
Before.
And yes. The best is to block the B.
Dengan dolar, yes.
Mm-hmm. Start. And how many characters? Mm-hmm. How many characters we know, because each character is
20.
This.
Yeah.
And now we need the formula that gives us 1 for A
mm-hmm.
and 21 for B, yeah, 31 for C.
For C.
Yeah.
Yes.
So we can do this.
Character width plus 1. Yes. Okay.
All right. So
yang B16 itu kalian blok dulu ya. Yes.
And we go down.
Yeah. Again, few more.
Oh, well, yeah. Perfect. Ugly.
Okay, masih jelek, tapi kita bisa cari solusinya. Gampang.
We know what to do. Yes.
Yes.
We use this, correct?
Format
painter.
Format painter. Kalian tinggal copy aja, oh my god.
And now we see that we have only A, even though here we had all the letters. Uh-huh. Yes.
Tadinya kan dari satu kolom itu kan kita punya A, B, C, D dan semua alfabet gitu ya. Tapi kali ini kita pindahin satu-satu ke setiap kolom nih. Makanya sekarang di kolom B ini kita di sel yang bawah itu kita punya satu alfabet aja, satu huruf yaitu A doang. Sekarang kita copy.
B. So, but I wonder when we go down, we still not remember this information. Okay. So to do it, yeah, you see, because now it goes disappears when we go down, yes?
Yep.
If we very often you want to keep the top lines, yeah, then you, for example, go here, and you go to view, freeze paints, yeah, and now when you go down, you see,
mm-mm.
You can
ini
still
di-freeze, dibekukan, jadinya kalau kalian mau scroll ke atas atau ke bawah, kalian nggak dibingungin sama ini semua, karena di sini nggak beku gitu ya.
More of this.
Yep. More. Yes.
Wonderful. So now this looks a bit ugly. So the way to do it.
Kasih jarak.
The columns.
Kita select semua.
And then we want all these columns selected to be like column B.
Mm-mm.
So you just take column
double,
B. And you adjust a little bit.
Kayak,
and when you leave.
Yeah.
Now all the columns are
sama.
Like column B. Huh?
Yep.
Yeah, looks perfect. Good.
Copy.
So what do we need to do next? Let's see. Next, yes. We want to take each letter, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, kita mau ngambil setiap huruf dari kata itu.
Hmm. So we want to take M alone, A alone, yeah, N alone, yes?
Yep.
Okay, let's do it. So we know what to do now, yes?
Yes.
It's the same as before.
Yes.
Meet again.
Yes. Okay.
So we take our text.
Mm-hmm. Kita ambil teks yang mau kita pilih.
We take first one and mm-hmm. we block.
Kita kasih dolar untuk ngeblok.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And then we know one at a time. Yeah.
Yes.
So this would be the M.
Yeah. Dari Manhattan kita mau ngeprint satu-satu jadi kayak M, A, N gitu. Okay.
Yeah.
Yep. Sekarang kita punya Manhattan, tapi ini kekecilan banget.
Ugly, so control one to change the formatting.
Yep.
Consolas is okay, but something big, like 20.
22,
yeah.
Probably.
22.
Yep.
Nice and
sekarang
big.
Kita udah punya Manhattan.
And then you can see alignment, for example, you can say center.
Center,
okay, perfect, so what we did? We took this and we separated in each letter.
Yeah, okay.
Now, what we want is that below here, we put the A.
Mm-mm.
Yes, and below N, you know, we put the N.
Yes.
So, let's do it.
Yeah.
So, the A is the first. Yeah, the B is the second. So, we need something that takes A and says 1.
1.
Yeah,
okay.
T, whatever, and says whatever T is. Yes,
Mm-mm.
H, 8. Yes.
Mm-mm. Istilahnya kita tuh mau tahu huruf A itu ada di angka berapa. Misalnya kan A, B, C, D. A itu 1, 2, 3, 4. Berarti D itu 4, A itu 1 gitu ya. Oke.
Yeah, if we call that this is the code, yeah. Also here we want the code.
The code. Okay, so kita mau cari kode nya.
All right, let's find the formula. So first of all, let's go back.
Balik lagi kita coding game.
Coding game. Because they were saying something very interesting. The information we have here, is actually this information.
The string.
Yeah, the string characters. A, B, C, D, J, K, and then
question mark. Okay. Nah, kita copy, kita pindahin ke Excel. Sini kita paste. Yeah.
So, as always, we try to do paste special.
Yes.
As
lalu
always, text and not HTML.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sekarang kita udah punya alfabetnya. All characters.
Another way of doing it, to give it a name, is like this, we saw in the past.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. Okay, so now what we want to do is A is the first here, B is the second there.
Nah, jadi itu istilahnya kayak ini kan ada A, B, C, sampai Z, bahkan ada question mark di belakangnya. Nah, sekarang kita mau kasih istilahnya angka di bawahnya yang menunjukkan kalau A itu 1, B itu 2, C itu 3, D itu 4, dan seterusnya.
So we need to find, for example, the M inside there. Yes? So let's...
M itu nomor berapa sih, gitu ya.
Let's move to text. And let's say what we want. We want to... Well, we want to find a text inside a text, for example. Oh, that was too difficult. Okay, just fine works.
Okay.
Otherwise, you can go in all the text and you search. Yeah, they're not that many. Yeah, and say, fine, sounds good. Let me see. Find text within text.
Text.
Sounds good.
Yep. Berarti ini yang kita inginkan, find, okay?
Yeah, so we need to find, for example, the M.
M.
And we block.
Pakai dolar, yes.
Within text.
Kita ambil this alphabet, semua alphabetnya, all characters. Lalu,
And voila, M.
Sekarang kita dapat di sini, kalau M itu nomor 13. A itu nomor 1, N itu nomor 14, H itu nomor 8, A itu nomor 1 lagi, gitu ya. Okay, sekarang kita udah dapat kodenya.
H8.
Yes.
H8. So it works very well.
Wow! Yay!
Good formula. Very good. Now we need to show the letter, yes?
Yes.
The art. We need to show the art.
Kita mau tunjukkan seninya sekarang. Yes.
Okay.
Sekarang kita udah memisahkan setiap hurufnya, lalu juga kita sudah mencarikan kodenya, dan sekarang kita akan lihat seninya. Okay.
So we saw this in onboarding,
yes.
When we have many things and we want to fish the one we're interested in,
yes,
in a group.
Yes.
And that was index, the most
index.
Important. Index, the most important formula in Excel. I always say that. Okay, so what we need? Well, we need an array. Well, the array is going to be all these.
Semuanya nih, kita ambil semuanya sampai 28.
And I want to block the B actually.
Yes, take a dollar. Okay.
Okay, and then we want to fish using this.
Okay, sekarang kita udah ngeprint M di sini. Dan sekarang kita mau ngeprint semuanya A, N, H, A, T. Yep.
Perfect.
Sekarang kita udah ngeprint semuanya. Yay! Kita udah dapat.
Let's make it look a bit prettier.
Yep.
So maybe
be red.
Indonesian style.
Oh, Indonesian flag. Red and white.
All right. So, Manhattan. So this is the solution of the first
case.
Actually, the first case was E.
E, sebenarnya kasus pertama itu cuma E ya, cuma minta ditunjukin E.
The second case, Manhattan.
And
then the third case.
Manhattan. Iya, beda huruf kapital, ada huruf kapital, ada huruf kecil juga. Sedangkan ini kan baru huruf kapital semua.
So, okay. Manhattan.
Sekarang kita udah ganti ke Manhattan yang dimana M-nya itu besar, A-nya itu kecil, N kecil gitu kan, gak beraturan gitu.
And here is the result. So when the letter is uppercase,
dia ngerti apa yang harus dilakukan. Yes.
But tapi, lowercase, fails because it doesn't find it, here. Yes.
Sebelumnya kita itu baru melakukan untuk huruf kapital, untuk huruf kecil, komputer ini atau Excel ini belum tahu apa yang harus dilakukan. Dia nggak tahu kita harus ngeprint apa gitu ya, karena kita nggak kasih arahan ke dia. Sekarang kita kasih arahan upper text.
Yes, so we have to convert this in upper. Mm-mm. Yes.
Kita ubah ya, kita convert.
Mm-hmm. So we go here, as always we say upper case help.
Go. Okay. Di sini ada upper convert a text string to all uppercase later. Okay. Kita klik Manhattan. Yep.
Perfect. Yes, Manhattan.
Manhattan.
Great. So we need to focus on this one now. Yeah.
Yes.
On this one. Perfect. So here. Yes. Instead of taking input text,
yes,
we're going to take
the Manhattan.
The Manhattan. But let's give it a beautiful name. Yes, let's call it
Manhattan.
Upper text. Yes.
Yes.
And then we'll here instead of input text,
we put also
upper text. And then control copy, control V, and voila.
Yep.
So now Manhattan. Manhattan. Even though we have this input, it still works.
Mm-mm. Kita lihat.
Yeah, so here it is.
Manhattan
gives
Manhattan
this output. And yes, we give the same output, success. Great! So now let's look at the next case.
Yes.
Next case, there is this very strange thing. Oh, this looks like a problem. But the output, yeah, it's very interesting. The characters which are not in the alphabet, we have to use the question mark. Yeah, you see?
Yes.
Also here, question mark. Okay, so that's what we need to do. Question mark. Art.
Okay.
Copy.
Nah, sekarang kita ganti di sini inputnya. Kita masukin M, lalu A-nya itu pakai add gitu kan. Yang dimana di sini juga dia nggak tahu apa yang harus dilakukan. Yes. Nah.
So here what we need to do, we have to put an if, basically. Yeah.
Kita
so,
harus ganti gitu. At ini gitu jadi apa? Jadi question mark, kita lihat ya.
Non-alphabet.
Kalau bukan alfabet.
And we're gonna put an if. Let's see.
Yes.
If we did this the same in a TOR. Yes? When we had this NA. Remember?
Yeah.
So we're gonna use the same formula.
Yes. Yeah? Kita if, pakai if, lalu is number.
This is a number.
C30 kita masukin.
Show the number. Yeah. Otherwise.
Otherwise.
In this case, we need to show
20,
the question
27.
Mark. Yeah,
yes.
27.
Nah, di sini tuh kan sebenarnya A B C D sampai Z itu cuma 26, ya kan? Tapi aku itu bikinnya sampai 28. Kenapa? Karena 27-nya itu aku pakai buat question mark, 28-nya itu aku pakai buat nol, nggak ada apa-apa gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya kalimatnya atau katanya itu udah habis, kolom selanjutnya jangan masukin apa-apa gitu, biarin aja kosong gitu. Soalnya kan kalau misalnya kita nggak suruh kayak gitu, dia akan masukin secara otomatis angka 1, yang dimana angka 1 itu A gitu ya kan. Jadi kita bukan itu yang kita mau, okay?
Perfect. So now instead of this, we want to use that.
Mm-hmm.
A trick to do it is you press F2.
Yes.
F2, mm-hmm. And then you, with the mouse, you take this,
yeah,
and we put it where you want.
Yes.
So instead of here, you move it there.
Mm-mm.
Press Enter.
Okay.
And then you copy the formula everywhere.
Yes. Okay. Yep. Nah, sekarang di sini jadi deh Manhattan. Tadi kan inputnya kan Manhattan, yang mana A-nya itu pakai add ya. Nah, sekarang di sini setiap add itu kita ganti pakai question mark. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Jadi apa aja selain alfabet, misalnya simbol apa aja selain alfabet, selain A sampai Z, itu kita pakainya question mark ya. Nah, di sini inputnya itu tadi Manhattan, A-nya itu diganti pakai add kan, sedangkan add itu bukan alfabet. Nah, jadinya question mark di sini. Jadinya Manhattan gitu. Okay.
Wonderful. So now we can try to put something else. Mm-hmm. Yeah? I mean, we solved all the puzzles, yes?
Yes.
We already did this with these special characters.
Yeah.
And of course, it works also with the normal normal characters.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, so if we take, for example, this case, with the normal characters, which are a little bit not beautiful, but copy. And then we go here.
Text. Okay.
Yeah, and we take this.
Mm-mm.
So you see A B C D Z and then A B C D
E F G. Jadi kita juga bisa melakukan, meminta dia untuk mengeprint dengan apa aja gitu seninya, tergantung input yang kita berikan.
Yeah, so it works also with the other alphabet. Perfect. Okay, let's try something else. Yes?
Yes.
Let's try it. Christy? Yes?
Kita lihat apa yang terjadi.
Will it work with Christy? Will it work, yes or no?
Yes, of course.
But I have a doubt. So it works until here.
Sampai Christy doang. Hmm? Yeah.
But then when it's shorter, at the moment we have...
Yang tadi aku bilang, aku kan tadi bilang nih ke kalian alasan kenapa aku taruh di kolom itu nomornya itu sampai 28. Ya karena ini, jadinya tuh kayak gini, kalau misalnya kita belum kasih komen apa-apa, ini tuh masih belum ngerti gitu apa yang harus dilakukan gitu. Nah di sini ada Christy, tapi kan Christy itu lebih pendek daripada Manhattan ya. Nah jadinya sisanya dia pakai AAA secara otomatis, di mana A itu angka 1. Nah ini tuh kayak default gitu tau gak sih, yang kita harus kontrol nih sekarang. Okay.
So what we want to do is that if
too
this
short,
this is nothing, for example, then use, well, we can use
28
where the other is nothing.
Nah, di sini kan nggak ada apa-apa tuh di angka 28 ya. Kalau 27 kan tadi ada question mark, 28 itu kalau misalnya katanya udah habis, tapi masih ada sisanya ya kita masukin 28 ini. Okay, kita masukin nomor 28.
Okay, so let's this.
Yep.
Yeah, now the normal numbers, but here we put 28. Mm-hmm. And now here we want to use 28, yes? Yep. So again, we press F2. And then we drag this where
ke
we
atas,
want.
Ya. Kemana aja sih yang kalian butuhkan? Yes.
Copy everywhere. Voila!
Sekarang dia tahu kalau 28 itu nggak ada apa-apa. 27 tadi ada question mark. 28 nggak ada apa-apa. 1 sampai 26 itu ada alfabet. Okay. Jadi kesimpulannya di sini tadi kan kata Manhattan itu lebih banyak hurufnya daripada Christy ya. Kalau Christy kan cuma 6 huruf nih. Kalau Manhattan tadi kan lebih. Nah, jadinya itu sisanya tadi dia tuh by default gitu jadi 111. Nah, sekarang kita udah fix nih ya. Sekarang dia ngerti apa yang harus dilakukan dengan menaruh 28. 28 itu nggak ada apa-apa gitu. Kalau misalnya kata-katanya itu ada simbol di luar alfabet, dia akan taruh nomor 27. Tapi kalau misalnya habis sampai situ, dia akan taruh nomor 28 yang dimana selesai gitu. Okay. Sampai sini selesai. Gimana menurut kalian? Seru kan belajar pakai Excel? Okay, like kalau kalian suka, komen kalau kalian ada pertanyaan, dan subscribe kalau kalian gak mau ketinggalan puzzle-puzzle lainnya. Bye!